So today we are coming to you from beautiful Sacramento, City of Trees. That's why your nose is running.
Excellent.
City of Pollen.
Good to know there's a reason.
Yes, that's why everyone's nose is running and my car is covered in green dust.
That would explain it.
Yes. Yeah. But that's where we are. And we are here as we are rolling out four new designs of rice paper by me that are from my original artwork. And it is the Birds and Blooms rice paper. So we've got hummingbirds, chickadees, cardinals. This is a test. You see, she's waiting for me to mess up.
I'm waiting.
And finches.
Still not in alphabetical order. We've done this twice, and she still didn't get them in alphabetical order.
Why do we have to have it in alpha order?
It just appeals to my weird nature.
Oh.
I'm the girl Sheldon.
Got it. Who's Sheldon?
Oh, you don't watch Big Bang?
I don't watch TV.
Well, I mean, I don't watch TV anymore either, but what is the matter with you? How can you not know who Sheldon? I'm appalled. Anyway.
Okay, Sheldon.
Yeah, whatever. Okay, so hummingbirds. I call dibs on the hummingbirds. Just a little journal page spread. I'm going to talk about. I don't know if you can really see this. There's this lovely tone-on-tone stamping that I did with Elizabeth's. A couple of the botanicals, the long-stem botanical foam stamps. And I grabbed, is this a finch?
That is a finch.
I grabbed one of the finches, and I'll show you how you can put rice paper on a busy background and not have it affect the rice paper, because that is an important thing. And you're actually going to talk about that when you work on your thing.
That's an American goldfinch. You're from the Northeast. You should know that.
I'm not a bird person. I don't belong to the Audubon Society. It's a bird. It has wings.
It's a North American goldfinch on a coneflower, also known as echinacea. My goodness. You need to get out more.
The flower I can identify, not so much the birds. Can you just show them your thing, please?
Okay, yes. This is my thing. Cardinals, texture paste with a little shimmer. Cradled panel, lots of fun.
Lots of fun.
Lots of steps to this. Nothing complicated, no. Just waiting for things to dry.
Well, it's like an oven outside, so the stuff goes outside and it comes in really quick.
Yes.
It was 105 the other day. I don't know what it was today, but warm covers it.
Triple digits here in the City of Trees. You can put your stuff outside the front door and it cooks immediately.
Almost as good as an egg on the sidewalk.
Right. We did burn our hands on the threshold to the doorway.
We did, honestly.
Could have cooked an egg there.
Yeah, absolutely. Links to the products, I remembered, can be found down below. And let's go make some fun.
All right, let's go do it.
All right.
Today we have been making projects with my brand new bird rice paper. What did we call these?
I have no idea. What is
Birds and Blooms.
Here you go.
Birds and Blooms rice paper, and this is chickadees. This is A4 rice paper printed in Italy. It is archival and fade proof, and it is a 30 GSM rice paper. It glues down beautifully. And we've got some beautiful chickadees with bright colors on this one. And then this sheet is called Cardinal, and we've got two male and a female cardinal and some cherry blossoms on that one. The next one is called Finches, and we have a couple finches on coneflowers, and then this one. And the last one is hummingbirds, and this one's called Hummers. And I have a feeling this one is going to be a favorite because these guys are a lot of fun and they're all very colorful and adorable, right?
Utterly adorable.
Yes. Utterly adorable.
Them and the chickadees. Those are my favorites.
Yeah, the chickadees. The chickadee is the state bird of Massachusetts, and Barb and I are fellow New Englanders. And so, you know, she's a cousin of Massachusetts in Rhode Island. So we're going to give her a high five for loving the chickadee, right?
Absolutely.
All right. So, for my project, I have already worked on two samples that I'm really excited to share with you. This first one is, you can see this was kind of easy because these two cardinals are right next to each other, kind of fitted together on the sheet of rice paper. So when I created this one, I just cut them out. And what I found through the process of doing this is leave the bottom straight, because then you can put it right down here, and then the only cut lines we have is up like that. So leave all the bottom of the paper on. Even if you slide it down further and wrap it over the edge like this, we get a nice solid bottom. So here's the first one. And this is on an 8x8 Art Alternatives cradled wood panel. And the cool part about that is I painted the edges of this whole thing red to pick up the color of the cardinals from the front. So the awesome thing about these cradled panels is you put your hanging wire in the insides here and string it up like this, and you don't have to frame this project. So when you're done with your colored edges and your cardinal project, it's ready to hang, which is really nice. So I, for this one, I had painted the sky color in the background first, but when I glued it down, I saw that the blue tint was coming through the face of the female cardinal. And you can see the difference in this sort of blue tint that showed up through her, because the paper is thin and glues down and that blue was showing through, but she's whiter. So the first time I painted the whole board blue, the second time I put them on just a prepared white gesso board. So I learned that. Then I used one of my Patterns for Layering stencils. Do you remember what this one is called? I was going to ask you that. I could see the fear in your eyes.
I was completely unprepared, sorry.
Completely unprepared. Anyway, it's one of the new Patterns for Layering stencils, and I applied this Ranger's metallic white texture paste through the stencil with a palette knife, spread it like butter through the stencil, and then once it dried, I put a little wash of blue on top of it with water, and you can see that that made the dark blue sort of collect around the edges of the raised pattern, and it gave it a little bit of a blue tint, which allowed it to blend into the background a little bit more. But you can see that shimmer that's really nice where it's catching the light, and that is a function of the metallic white of this texture paste. So the reason why what inspired me to do the texture paste is I was trying to camouflage the edge of where we cut the rice paper, because I was seeing that edge and I was like, how can I camouflage that edge? So it, what ended up being a challenge for the paper became my favorite part of this, because I really like the way that that texture paste looks on this piece, and it definitely camouflages that cut edge at the top. So that's the first one that I did. Then the next one that I did in this one, and you can see the difference with the female cardinals, she's much whiter in this one because I glued the paper down on a white board, and then I painted the blue around them, and I used the Crafter's Workshop Tangerine Stencil Butter on this one, and this is another Patterns for Layering stencil. What's it called?
No idea.
Nobody knows. Okay. But it is, we have all the links for the products below the video. But this was a little tricky, but well worth the effort. I wrapped the stencil butter pattern around the sides. So this has got a real feel for that floral kind of leafy pattern going around the sides. And I wanted to pick up this kind of ochre yellow color from the female cardinal. And again, to camouflage the edges of where I cut the paper. So this one is different, a different solution, but the same with the cradled panel and being able to wire it and hang it without a frame necessary. So, okay. So here's how I created my piece. So I determined that white was the best background to glue the rice paper onto. I've got some Dina Wakely gel medium, and it's a matte medium, and I like it in this squeeze cap dispenser, and a soft paintbrush, and I'm just gonna squeeze out a bunch of it right onto the surface here. You want to make sure you go up high enough for the cardinal and low enough to get across the bottom, and I'm just gonna spread that out in a nice thin layer everywhere. I'm also going to wrap the tail of the female cardinal and the male cardinal sort of around the edges, so I'll keep a little extra glue for that. I'll show you how to do that in a minute. Okay, so we got that all spread out, and I'm going to have the edge of his wing go off the side as well as her tail. So, and then I don't want to put it up too high, so I'm going to make sure they're both going off the edge a bit like that. So I'm going to smooth this out with the brush that still has the matte medium in it. That's the best way to get it flat, to just press any wrinkles out with the brush. And it really glues down beautifully. And then looks like I need a little bit more in the corner here. The corners are always the place you need to add a little extra because it's sometimes they peel when you don't get the glue all the way out there. So we're brushing this over the top. And then I'm just going to flip it here and put a little more glue on the edge. Ah, that was a lot more glue. And
just I'm snorting again.
Yes.
I've reached new lows.
And I'll just fold that over and it glues down really nice. And then I'll go to the other side, do the same thing. And I'll make sure I get enough glue in here. And then I'm going to fold that over like this. And then on the bottom, that way I have a perfect edge at the bottom. And the trick with this is put the glue in here like this. Bring the bottom forward. And then we're going to do the corners like a Christmas package. So I've got the bottom in, and then I bring this over like
that.
And I get a nice corner like that. And I don't have to worry about cutting a straight line at the bottom, right? And then again, the same thing. Glue the bottom down straight. Take this corner. Whoops. Take this corner and fold it over just like that. And then we have a nice edge all the way around. Here I can see I need a little more glue in there. Okay. And you can press out any wrinkles or bubbles with the paintbrush. That's really the best way to do it. And then we're just gonna let this dry. And I have found that with the glue that I've got on the edges, if I got any of it on the bottom of the board, the best way to let it dry so it doesn't stick to your table surface is to put your texture paste container down and then sit it on top. So we'll wait for that to dry and we'll be right back. Okay, so now I'm going to add some really pale blue up in this area to extend the color of the sky with the cardinals. So I'm gonna be using titanium white, because you see the solid square on here, that is more opaque than zinc white, and I want it to be more opaque so it'll really lighten my manganese blue. So I'm going to mix those up, try to create a really nice light pale blue, which is more white than you think. It's very close up here to the color of the white background. And I'm just gonna brush that in. I'm gonna come over the edge of the paper. I think it really could use a little bit of this because it's a slight purple tint to it. That's ultramarine. There we go. It's a little closer. So ultramarine, titanium white, and manganese blue. And I'm gonna come over the edge of the paper and also just paint the background of the board. And remember, I did this because I didn't want the blue sky color showing through the female cardinal. Whoops. Then I'm gonna put out just the white. And I'm gonna use my mini ink blender tool to sort of create some clouds. So I'm just gonna dab that titanium white and just sort of create a cloudy sky effect here. I'm gonna bring this color around the sides. So a little bit more white. But you can already see how I've blended with the mini ink blender tool. I've made those soft clouds and they really kind of blend into the rice paper nicely. So I'm gonna just come in with that pale blue on the sides. Everything dries fast here, except for when you're watching it, then it doesn't.
Oh, that was close.
Oh, I almost dropped that. Okay. So now we got the light blue all the way around the edges. And I'm gonna put out the white again, and I'm gonna bring the clouds around the edges with that blending tool. So I'm gonna bring the cloud from the front around the sides. I love this dabber tool for clouds. It's like my cloud tool. Look at that.
Works.
Right? Okay. So now we're going to let this dry, and the next step will be to add the texture paste. Okay, so the next step is to apply the texture paste to the now dry painted background. And Barb was kind enough to look up these stencil names. And this one is called Argyle, and this one is called Summer Blossoms. So I'm going to use the Argyle, and I'm going to put the metallic white texture paste through it and onto the background. And you could do it just at the top. That's what I'm thinking. I did it on this one. I did it at the bottom and at the top. But I think for every time I do this, I do it a little bit better, I think. So this time I'm just going to do it at the top, on the top part. Also, because I did not cut the paper down here, so I don't have any edges that I'm trying to camouflage. The first time I cut the paper down here. So we're just trying to get the top edge to blend in a little bit more. So I'm going to lay this over. And basically, this is sort of like buttering your toast, right? So you want to hang on to it. Your toast, not your toes.
No. Toast. Oh, sounds good.
Yeah, I'm hungry too.
At that point in the day where we're both hungry.
Thinking about food. So you want to hang on to it so it doesn't slide out of place. And you're going to put like a nice thin layer through the stencil. I try to get close in to the birds. When I lift this up, I'm going to use a wet paper towel to wipe off any paste that got in places that I didn't want it. So it dries a little slow, so you're going to have time to do that, sort of remove it in areas where you didn't want it. So out in this corner, and you can see the rice paper design through the stencil. That's helpful for the most part, so you can get close to the bird without overlapping him. And we'll go out to the corners here. And I'm
still waiting for the toast.
The toast, it's coming. Then I'm going to come down in the middle and just complete that one shape, I think. And here's the tricky part with this one, getting in that. Now, this doesn't dry super fast, but you do want to make sure you get it off the surface of your stencil. Not let it dry on there. Okay, I think that's pretty good. So let's lift it up and have a look. Yeah, that looks good. So now we'll just set this aside into the sink. And Barb has gotten me a nice wet paper towel. So I'm going to just sort of zip off the overhang on the edges. And then come in and see if it overlapped anywhere where I didn't want it, or if I have a partial bit of the pattern. So like, for example, in here, maybe in there. There you go. And then we're just gonna let this dry, and then we'll add the light pale blue wash on it, and we'll be all set. So you can see that definitely the texture definitely helps to camouflage the edge of the rice paper. The blend of titanium white, manganese blue, and a tiny bit of ultramarine blue in those Amsterdam paints really blended a color that was quite similar to the rice paper. So we'll let this dry, and then we'll add the wash. Okay, so the texture paste is dry, and now I'm going to come and put a little wash of manganese blue over the texture paste and the background. So I'm just going to put a little bit of that out onto our non-stick craft mat and add a little water, or a lot of water. Did I get you wet?
Nope, you did not. You gonna try again?
Yeah, I'm aiming for that. Yeah, I want this to be real watery because I just want it to sort of collect around the edges of the texture and not really make everything a lot darker. So I'm just gonna brush over real light. And you can come back in with a damp paper towel and wipe this off the high points if you want to, for it to be even more subtle.
Here's a paper towel.
Thanks. Wow, look at that. My assistant, she's fabulous.
That's right.
And I'm using a flat brush, which allows me to sort of get in the corners and get right up to the edges of the birds. And I'll bring that in here. And then I can just sort of wipe or dab until you get it to the level of something that you like. So you can always add more. And there you have it. We have a really nice texture paste with a little bit of shimmer, and the pattern of that kind of helps to camouflage the edge of the rice paper. And we've got these awesome cardinals that are facing each other and kind of positioned nicely. And I would sign it right down here. And we could even put a little wash around the edges, although I really like the clouds on the edges. So I think we're good. I think we're good. So just a couple of ideas of things you can do with the new Birds and Blooms rice papers.
There you go.
There you go.
I really adore the hummingbirds, and so I grabbed this one for me once I knew Elizabeth was going to work with the cardinals. All of these lovely little designs, and I decided that I wanted to do them on kind of a, well, not kind of, on a page spread, and this is where I ended up. I'm really pleased with this. It did present some challenges because I had to get my brain kind of going for what I was trying to do. This is what I started with. And the background was a little bit more peachy, and I came through, and this is one of Elizabeth's Dotty stencils. I can't remember the name of it because I didn't prepare well enough, evidently. But this ended up not being what I was looking for. I wanted something, this was soft and subtle, but this changed it. So I came over here and I kind of redid the background. And then Elizabeth and I were talking, and she suggested doing some tone on tone for the background, which I'm assuming you can see, and that's what I did. So to do that, I used these two foam stamps. This is named Spiral, and this one is named Leafy. And though you can almost not see it, if I bring this up right here, you can see there's a little bit of that peach color again. This is the stencil that's named Focus on the Positive, and I use that because I was, again, trying to get some color and pattern in the background. So what I'm going to do is just quickly show you what I did here. And you can see that the stamps are at varying heights. Super easy to do. I didn't have the exact color I was looking for, so I mixed it. Got a light pink, and this is Titanium Buff Light, which is going to give me a little bit of a peachy color, but for this page, that's perfect. Here, I want to say I used white, so I kept more to the pink family. So let's just put a little bit of, let's move this way, put a little bit of color out here, and then I'm going to mix it, and I'm going to smooth it out with a palette knife so that I can go ahead and stamp in it. And I'm not going to do a bunch of these, but I did want to mention that one of the things that I wanted to do was make certain that my stamped images were not all the same height, because that just looks a little weird, and you don't see anything like that in nature anyway. You want to get enough paint on there, but you don't want to goop it up too much. Right there, gooped up a little bit too much. So I'm going to stamp some of that off, and I just want to put a little bit more on there. And then I was thinking about height and the difference in height and how I wanted to get these out on there. And so that's really all I'm trying for here. And if I lift that up, now again, this is really subtle, but that's deliberate. That was exactly what I was trying for. A little bit too much there. I'm gonna put this face down on a wet paper towel, and I'm gonna bring in Spiral. And I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna stamp this. And I want these kind of close together so that I have a little bit of a cluster. And as you go along, you can kind of do these things. You can build these sections, or you can build this whole kind of vignette that is all of these designs. So I'll come back and just do one more here like this. Again, I want them at different heights. You can curve these stems. So if I come back with Leafy, and I touch it in here again, and I get my color on there, a little bit too much right there, and I come in here, I can, if I put this down, let's make this taller, let's make sure we have paint all the way down. I can come in and I can curve this. If I put the head of the flower down, or the head of the botanical in this case, since it's a leaf, and then I can just go ahead and get that curve in there. So again, you can't see a whole heck of a lot here, but that was really deliberate because, again, I was looking for that tone on tone look. I'm really happy with this. A little bit of pen work on the border, a quote that kind of is fun about nature, and that page spread was done. When you have rice paper and you apply it to anything other than a solid surface or anything other than a solid white surface, one of the places where you can get in trouble is that this stuff has a tendency to be translucent when you put gel medium on it. The solution for that is to use gel medium and put it on a piece of white paper first, let it dry, and then cut it out. And it doesn't matter where I put this on the page, the background is not going to show through at all. Now, I could glue this on, but you don't need to see me do that. The ultimate point here is that if I put white paper on the back, I can put this any place and the background color or patterning or text is not going to show through, and it's not going to distort what I'm working with.
Okay, so that was tons of fun.
It was tons of fun. The imagery is beautiful. You can't go wrong. I mean, it's all done for you. You just got to cut it out and play with it.
Which is also fun.
Also fun.
Because it is about the process, not the end product, right? Art is about enjoying the time spent.
Yeah, but let's face it, sister. The end product is pretty darn
good. That's a pretty good end product. Yeah. This is true. So now it's my turn to tell you that all the links to the products used in this video can be found in the expanded description box down below.
When she shuts the camera off, I'm going to squish a pie in her face.
I'm so hungry. I would go for the pie.
I know, right? We are starving. It's time to go get some food.
Time to go get dinner.
All right.
Bye.
Bye.